Hello friends, myself, Darshan Pandit, Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Science and Engineering from Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. So today we are going to see about fractal lines and surfaces. So at the end of this session, student will be able to identify and distinguish various types of fractals. So here, first we are going to see fractal and fractal types, that is exactly self-similarity fractal, quasi self-similarity fractal and statistically self-similarity fractal. So fractal is discovered by mathematician Dr. Benoit Mandelbrot. The word fractal is derived from Latin word that is fractus, which means broken. A fractal is a mathematical object that is both self-similar and chaotic. Self-similar is nothing but as you magnify, you will see the object over and over again in its parts. And chaotic is nothing but these fractals are infinitely complex. Fractals are a very complex picture generated by a computer from a single formula, and they are created using iterations. One formula is repeated with slight different values over and over again, taking into account the result from previous iteration. Fractal is defined in mathematical limit of infinitely many iterations. So the example of fractal you can see. So here, see, whenever you zoom this object, you can see the same object is repeated. So you can see this part. So whenever you zoom this thing, again you are going to see the same part. See. So fractal types, the level of details remains same as we zoom in. Okay. So as we have seen in example, surface roughness and profile will be same as we zoom in. So types of fractals, that is exactly self-similarity, quasi self-similarity and statistical self-similarity fractals. So let us see these types one by one. Okay. Exactly self-similar fractal is strongest type of fractal, okay, which appear identical at different scales. So these fractals are defined by iterated function system. Okay. So in this we are having initiator and generator. Initiator is nothing but start with a given geometric shape, and generator is a pattern which replaces the subpart of initiator. So as an example, we are having Sierpinski triangle, Koch snowflake and fern leaf, etc. So Sierpinski triangle is a fractal described in 1915 by Sierpinski. Sierpinski triangle starts as a shaded triangle of equal length, and we split the triangle into four equal triangles by connecting the center of each side together and remove the central triangle. So we can then repeat this process on newly generated triangle, that is three newly created smaller triangle. So let us see the. So this process is repeated several times on newly created smaller triangle to arrive the picture displayed. Okay. A Sierpinski triangle is created infinitely repeating this construction process. So Sierpinski triangle example. So this is initiator and generator. Okay. And this is the iteration one of Sierpinski triangle, where we divide this triangle in equal halves and we remove the middle triangle. So this will create three new triangle. Okay. And again on this part, again this part is divided in three parts. Okay. Again this triangle is divided in three parts. Okay. So this process is repeated. Okay. So this is iteration two of Sierpinski triangle. Again, when we divide again this part, we get iteration three of Sierpinski triangle. So whenever we zoom this part, so we see the original triangle. See, in this way we get the Sierpinski triangle. Okay, so whenever you zoom this part, okay, so whenever you zoom this part, you get exactly same structure is repeated over the fractal. Okay, so this is exactly self-similarity fractal. After that, we are having Koch snowflake triangle. So it is discovered by von Koch in 1904. Okay, it start with straight line of length 1 and recursively we divide it into 3 equal parts and replace middle section with triangular bump with sides of length 1/3. So now new length will be 4/3. So let us see the example. So this is the initiator in Koch snowflake, after that generator, and each side is replaced by generator, so that we will get the first iteration. So stage 0, after that each side is replaced by generator, so this will be the stage 1. After that again each side is replaced by generator, so that you will get stage 2, that is Koch star in stage 2. After that stage 3, and this process will be repeated. And whenever you zoom this part, you can find the initial stage. So last is fern leaf. So where you can see, so whenever you zoom this part, so you can find identical similar structure is repeated over a wide range of length scale. So these are the examples of exactly self-similarity fractals. Next type is quasi self-similarity. So this is a looser form of self-similarity fractal which appears approximately identical at different scale. So in this we won't get exactly self-similar, but approximately it is identical at different scale. So it contains small copies of entire fractal in a distorted and degenerate form. So these are defined by recurrence relation, example Mandelbrot set, satellite approximation. So this is the Mandelbrot set. So in this we can see the Mandelbrot set. So whenever you zoom this thing, you will find the approximate identical fractal. Next type is statistically self-similarity fractal. So this is weakest type of self-similarity, as fractal has numerical or statistical measure which are preserved across scales. Random fractals are example of fractals which are statistically self-similar but neither exactly nor quasi self-similar. So example, you can have coastline, microscopic or root fractals. So this is the example of coastline. So where you can see statistical self-similarity fractal. So in this fractal you cannot find exactly similar or approximate. Okay, so it is statistically self-similar, that is it is in a distorted form. So it is the microscopic self-similarity fractal. So here you can pause the video and answer this question. Distinguish between exactly self-similarity, quasi self-similarity and statistical self-similarity fractals. So here, so form of exactly self-similarity fractal, it is the strongest form of self-similarity. Quasi is loose form of self-similarity and statistical is weakest form of self-similarity. So scales, so in exactly self-similarity fractals appear identical at different scale. So fractals appear approximately identical at different scale, and fractals are measured numerical and statistical, which preserved across the scale. Examples of self-similarity is Sierpinski triangle, coarse snowflake and fern leaf. Quasi self-similarity examples are Mandelbrot set and satellite approximation, and statistically self-similarity fractals are microscopic, coastline, etc. So these are the references which I have used to create this video. Thank you.